فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
I'm going to speak about a topic that hasn't been spoken about in many of the gatherings as I feel like the way it deserves to be spoken about, especially in the West. People love some fatawat from some of the ulama, ajilla, honorable scholars, and their aqwal, but then tend to take that as an easy option in staying in the dar of the kuffar. And they really don't understand when the ulama say that the person can establish their religion. Some of them don't even know what is meant by it. He assumes that it means by establishing your religion, it means that you're able to pray your 5 daily prayers, you can fast the month of Ramadan, that's not what the ulama said in regards to establishing your religion. Inshallah, it will come to us. Also, what did the ulama say regarding the people who have the ability to travel? What's meant by ability? Let the ulama define that in order for us to know what is meant by ability here. This topic is very big. I have aqwal, I have views of scholars who are great in number and quantity, who spoken about this issue, such as an Imam Ibn al-Arabi, the great Maliki scholar, Ibn Qudam al-Maqdisi, Majduddin al-Barakat, rahimahullah, the grandfather of Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah, and al-Qurtubi, al-Imam al-Nawawi, al-Imam Ibn Taymiyyah himself, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, al-Mardawi, Abdul Ra'uf al-Munawi, al-Mar'i Ibn Yusuf al-Karami, Mansur Ibn Yusuf al-Buhuti, Shawkani rahimahullah, أبو الطيب الصديق حسن خان, إبراهيم بن محمد بن سالم الطويان. So I have scholars who have spoken about this issue, who have brought their evidences and everything that they believe of this issue. And it'd be nice that some people actually went out their way to read the aqwal of the ulama, the contemporary scholars no doubt, and the previous scholars who preceded them in knowledge and preceded them in time, what they said regarding this issue of hijrah, المفارقة ديار المشركين. So what I want to speak about is the first point, inshallah, or the first mabhath is going to be النصوص المتعلقة, the evidences that are connected to al-hijrah, immigrating, ومفارقة ديار المشركين or ديار الشرك والمشركين, and leaving the lands of the disbelievers and the disbelievers themselves, the evidences that have come regarding this. Allah said in the Quran subhanahu wa ta'ala في محكم تنزيله وهو أصدق القائلين بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. In سورة النساء آية 97 to آية 100, Allah says, إن الذين توفاهم الملائكة ظالمي أنفسهم قالوا فيما كنتم قالوا كنا مستضعفين في الأرض قالوا ألم تكن أرض الله واسعة فتهاجروا فيها فأولئك مأواهم جهنم وساءت مصيرا إلا المستضعفين من الرجال والنساء والولدان لا يستطيعون حيلة ولا يهتدون سبيلا فأولئك عسى الله أن يعفو عنهم وكان الله عفوا غفورا ومن يهاجر في سبيل الله يجد في الأرض مراغما كثيرا وسعة ومن يخرج من بيته مهاجرا إلى الله ثم يدركه الموت فقد وقع أجره على الله وكان الله غفورا رحيما. الله سبحانه وتعالى said in this ayah, the 97th ayah in Surah An-Nisa to ayah 100, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, verily, as for those whom the angels take in death while they are wronging themselves, as they stayed among the disbelievers, even that though immigration was obligatory on them, the angels say to them, in what condition were you? They reply, we were weak and oppressed on the earth. The angels then say to them, was not the earth of Allah spacious enough for you to immigrate? Such men will find their abode in hellfire. What an evil destination. Except the weak ones among men, women, and children who cannot devise a plan, nor are they able to direct their way. These are they whom Allah is likely to forgive, and Allah is ever often pardoning, often forgiving. He who immigrates from his home in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find on earth many dwelling places and plenty to live by. And whosoever leaves his home as an immigrant to Allah and his messenger, and death overtakes him, his reward is then surely incumbent upon Allah, and Allah is ever often forgiving, most merciful. In this tafsir of this ayah that I recited, Al-Allamah ibn Kathir in the tafsir, he says, قَالَ الضِّحَاكِ Ibn Muzahim Dhahak says, نَزَلَتْ This ayah came down, فِي نَاسٍ مِنَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ It came down in a group of the hypocrites. تَخَلَّفُوا عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ They stayed away from the battle of the jihad. تَخَلَّفُوا عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ بِمَكَّةِ They stayed back when the Prophet done migration to Medina. وَخَرَجُوا These people came out مَعَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ with the polytheist. Hey, يوم بدر, in the day of Badr. فَأُصِيبُوا فِي مَنْ أُصِيبَ And it was, they were then killed, some of those who were killed in the battle of Badr by the Muslims. فَنَزَلَتْ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ This ayah came down عَامَّةً general, Ibn Kathir is saying. فِي كُلِّ in everyone مَنْ أَقَامَ بَيْنَ ظَهْرَانَيِّ الْمُشْرِكِينَ وَهُوَ قَادِرٌ عَلَى الْهِجْرَةِ This ayah came down upon every individual who stays amongst the disbelievers and he has the ability to do migration. وليس متمكنا من إقامة الدين and that a person is not able to fulfill his religion, he can't do his religion. فهو that person ظالم لنفسه he is a transgressor and a wrongdoer لنفسه to his soul مرتكبا حراما and he is a person who is doing sin بالإجماع with consent وبنص هذه الآية and the evidence that is in this verse حيث يقول تعالى where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says إن الذين توفاهم الملائكة those in which Allah took their souls ظالمي أنفسهم whilst they were wronging themselves souls so how were they wronging themselves Ibn Kathir says أي بترك الهجرة by leaving off my immigrating by leaving off immigration قالوا فيما كنتم what were you upon أي the question this is what is going to be said to them he said Ibn Kathir أي لما مكثتم هاهنا وتركتم الهجرة why is it that you remained with the disbelievers and you did not and you left off hijrah وقوله تعالى and the speech of Allah ومن يهاجر anyone who does hijrah في سبيل الله in the cause of Allah يجد he will find في الأرض in this earth مراغما كثيرا وسعة he will find in it مراغم the Arabs the word مراغم أولا in the Arabic language is a مصدر the Arabs they said راغم فلان قومه مراغما ومراغمة Ibn Abbas said مراغم is تحول من أرض إلى أرض is when a person changes from one land to another This is the call of who? Abdullah ibn Abbas and the call of Dhihak and Rabi' ibn Anas and Thawri, Sufyan al-Thawri. That person will find from the land in which he left and he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he done it in the cause of Allah, Allah will give him on the earth or he will find on the earth many dwelling places and plenty to live by. Muraghaman, kathiran wasa'ah. So muragam is dwellings. Al-Imam al-Alusi, rahimahullah, in his Ruh al-Ma'ani, he says, بعد قوله تعالى, after the speech of Allah, أَلَمْ تَكُنْ أَرْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَةً فَتُهَاجِرُوا فِيهَا إِسْتَدَلَّ بَعْضُهُمْ بِالْآيَةِ عَلَى الْوُجُوبِ الْهِجْرَةِ Some of the scholars use this verse as an evidence to show the compulsory obligation of doing hijrah. مِنْ مَوْضِعٍ لَا يَتَمَكَّنُ الرَّجُلُ فِيهِ مِنْ إِقَامَةِ دِينِ In a place where a man, or a woman of course, he or she is not able to establish their religion. وَهُوَ مَذْهَبُ الْإِمَامِ مَالِكِ And this is the madhab, the school of thought of Imam Malik. وَنَقَلَ ابْنُ الْعَرَبِي And Ibn Arabi has transmitted this to us. وُجُوبُ الْهِجْرَةِ To do hijrah مِنَ الْبِلَادِ الْوَبِيئَةُ أَيْضًا From the land in which a person is not able or can't establish his religion. Also, وَجَاءَ فِي كِتَابٍ in the book الْعِبْرَةُ مِمَّا جَاءَ فِي الْغَزْوَةِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ وَالْهِجْرَةِ who's owned by Abu Tayyib Sadiq Hassan Khan, page 217, he says, وَقَدْ اسْتُدِلَّ بِهَذِهِ الْآيَةِ meaning إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تُوَفَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ ظَالِمِ أَنفُسِهِمْ is talking about. This ayah has been used as evidence عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْهِجْرَةَ وَاجِبَةٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مَنْ كَانَ بِدَارِ الشِّرْكِ that the hijrah is wajib upon every person who lives amongst the polytheists, the mushrikeen. أو بِدَارٍ يُعْمَلُ فِيهِ بِالْمَعَاصِي or in a land where the sins are being done جِهَارًا in the open. إِذَا كَانَ قَادِرًا if the person has the ability عَلَىٰ الْهِجْرَةِ he has the ability to do hijrah. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ مِنَ الْمُسْتَضْعَفِينَ and he's not from those who are unable to do. لِمَا فِي هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ مِنَ الْعُمُومِ because in this ayah there's a generalization. وَإِنْ كَانَ السَّبَبُ خَاسًا even that though the reason it came down is specific. وَظَاهِرُهَا عَدَمُ الْفَرْقِ بَيْنَ مَكَانٍ وَمَكَانٍ وَزَمَانٍ وَزَمَانٍ and there is no difference from the apparentness of this ayah. There is no difference between one place over another place or a time over another time. Meaning there's no difference from Mecca to Medina than London to Saudi Arabia or London to a Muslim country. There is no difference. And the time is not a difference, meaning the time of the messenger and the time of today. It's the same. Also, Sadiq Hassan Khan goes on to say, the call of Allah, وَمَنْ يُهَاجِرْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ يَجِدْ فِي الْأَرْضِ مُرَاغَمًا كَثِيرًا وَسَعَةً لَمَّا نَزَلَتْ هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ هَاجَرَ إِلَىٰ أَرْضِ الْحَبَشَةِ قَوْمٌ When this ayah came down, a group of the companions, they went to the land of Habasha, Abyssinia. وَبَقِيَ قَوْمٌ فِيهِمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَىٰ And some people from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remained upon, the Prophet didn't leave. عَلَيْهِ صَلَىٰ فَهَاجَرُوا إِلَىٰ الْمَدِينَةِ الشَّرِيفَةِ They then hijrah to the land of Medina later. وَوَجَبَتِ الْهِجْرَةَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ مَفْتُونٍ لَا يَقَدِرُ عَلَىٰ إِظْهَارِ دِينِينَ And this was made compulsory upon every person مفتون who is being tested لا يقدر على إظهار دينه he cannot establish his religion. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم because Abu Talib was alive, his uncle, and because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was ذو نسب, he was a person of tribe, and the people who were harming him were from his tribe, صلوات الله وسلامه عليه, because our Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم from the children of Abd Manaf, he was Hashim, and the people that were harming him were other than Hashim al-Muttalib. The tribes that were harming him from the children of Abd Manaf was Abd al-Shams and Abd al-Dar. And Abd al-Uzza and Zuhra and Adi, tribe of Umar al-Khattab and Tame Abu Bakr's tribe, they were the ones that were harming the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Other than Hashim al-Muttalib, they were together all the time. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had still a tribe with him in Medina, Mecca that was there to help him, to support him. Like Abu Talib did to support his son, his Ibn Akh, his nephew, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi, and stood up for him. So, but Ammar ibn Yasir and Bilal ibn Rabaha, these ones, they were mustad'afin, they were weak, they weren't able to establish their religion. So they were told to go to Abyssinia, to establish their religion there, and stay there until Allah brings an faraj and opening for the believers. That's what Al-Imam Siddiq Hassan Khan mentioned in regards to that. So it became hijrah upon anyone whose religion is being tested on him. Inshallah, we'll come to this in details. Now we're just going to read the aqwal of the ulama. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in another ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَهَاجَرُوا وَجَاهَدُوا بِأَمْوَالِهِمْ وَأَنفُسِهِمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آوَوا وَنَصَرُوا أُولَئِكَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يُهَاجِرُوا مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ وِلَايَتِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى يُهَاجِرُوا وَإِنِ اسْتَنْصَرُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ فَعَلَيْكُمُ النَّصْرُ إِلَّا عَلَى قَوْمٍ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَهُمْ مِيثَاقٌ والله بما تعملون بصير والذين كفروا بعضهم أولياء بعض إلا تفعلوه تكن فتنة في الأرض وفساد كبير. This ayah is in Surah Al-Anfal.